Hello and welcome to Adelux on this new Lutron Homeworks QS tutorial, where I will share with you my experience as an independent Lutron programmer. Today, I'd like to quickly review how to set up area scenes as well as where they can be used. So, without further ado, let's do it. Area scenes are lighting scenes that are set up from one single place. Once set up, we can access and use those scenes at various places in our Lutron Homeworks QS database. The main advantage being that when you make a change in one of those scenes, it gets automatically updated in the entire database, in every place where that scene is being used, all in one single operation, which really helps optimizing time when programming and maintaining a Lutron Homeworks QS system. We've already reviewed different use of area scenes on separate tutorials, and you can find the links on the comment section below. Area scenes are automatically created every time we create a room, and they are only for lighting circuits. Let me select the master bedroom here, for example. As we can see, we already have four scenes and an off that are already pre-programmed by the Homeworks QS system. By default, scene 1 has all the lighting circuits in the master bedroom already set to 100%. Same thing for scene 2, but with the circuit set to 75%, scene 3 is set to 50%, and scene 4 is set to 25%. We also have an off scene with all the circuits set to off or 0%. From here, I can add additional area scenes if I need to by clicking on the plus sign here, or delete some of the ones I've added by clicking on a minus sign. Please note that the default ones, scene 1, 2, 4 and off, cannot be deleted. I also like to edit the name of the scenes to give additional information on what they do. I found it very useful during the programming process of my projects. I can navigate to the various rooms in my database either by using the drop-down list here or by using the Next Previous Area button there. So, at the start of my project, I can quickly set up or update the settings of all my area scenes all in one go, ready to use later. Let me go back to my master bedroom and select Master Bedroom Area Scene 1. The majority of the settings on the right side of the screen are mainly to make quick, bulk changes to my area scenes. For instance, I can change the fade time for all my lighting circuits in one go, simply by changing the value in that box here. Or, if I want to use different fade time for each circuit, I can also untick the box and then make the change I want directly in the list of circuits below, like I'm doing here. Next, I can also make changes on the lighting levels, also in bulk. On this part of the screen here, I can, for example, change the dim level to 90%, and when I press on the set button here, all the dimmable lighting circuit will get that new setting. I can also use the up and down arrow to make incremental changes, but I need to make sure to press on the set button to apply those changes. Alternatively, I can use the drop-down list to make quick changes to predefined levels. Same thing with the switch levels, where I can make quick changes to the non-dimmable lighting circuits in that room. And if I am using DMX color changing loads, I can quickly apply the same color to all the DMX zones in that room from here. Now, to make individual changes on the lighting circuits, I can use this section of the screen here. First, I select the circuit I want to change using the Next and Previous button here, or by selecting the circuits directly by clicking on it. Then, I can use the slider, the up and down arrows, the values in the drop-down list, or I can type directly the percentage I need in that box here, followed by Enter to apply the change, as you can see here. To be fair, Since the changes are not live at this point, if I have to change the lighting levels on one or many circuits in that area scene, for example, I will simply just go and make the change directly in the list of circuits below, like I'm doing here on a few circuits. What I really like to do though, and what I also prefer if I have to change or fine-tune my area scenes later on during my project, is to, at that point, go live with the Lutron system by clicking on the Edit Live button here and make live changes to my area scenes. Once I'm happy with the settings of my area scenes, I can use them at different places in my database. First, I can trigger them from a keypad button by selecting lighting areas from the drop-down list of assignable items here, make sure I select the relevant area, and then select the area scene I want to use on that button. I can also use area scenes on contact closure inputs. So here, for example, let's say that when my contact closure input 1 closes, I want to activate the garage area scene 1. And when my contact closure open, I want to use the garage area scene off. I can use area scenes in Timeclock. I select the event I want to program and then assign the lighting area I want to trigger. I can also add multiple area scenes to a single input. So here, for example, when my garden lights turn on automatically at sunset, I can trigger area scene 1 in the front garden, area scene 2 in the back garden, as well as area scene 3 in the pool area. I can trigger area scenes on occupancy and select the area scene I want when the room is occupied and select the area scene I want when the room is unoccupied. I can make share scenes out of area scenes, and you can click on the card above to know more about it. I can use area scenes when programming sequences, and I can also customize green mode with area scenes, as well as security modes as I'm showing here. A final interesting place to know where you can find area scenes is in the integration screen. If you go to Tools, Configure Integration, and then select Areas from the drop-down list, what we see here is that each area has a unique integration ID number that can be used to send command to the Lutron Homeworks QS system to trigger area scenes from a third-party equipment. You can find more details about it by accessing the Lutron Integration Protocol document from this link here. To conclude, we saw all the various settings available to customize our area scenes. And those area scenes can be used to quickly program keypad buttons, contact closure inputs, time clock, occupancy, share scenes, sequences, green modes, and security modes, as well as being triggered from third-party equipment. The main advantage of using area scenes is that if we need to make a change, we just have to update the specific area scene and automatically that change will be applied everywhere that scene is being used in one single operation. Voila, there you have it, how to set up area scenes and where they can be used. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Please, if you have any question, let us know in the comment section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you can be updated when the next video is released. Good luck and talk to you again on the next tutorial.